a rare disease or a potential generic disease may not always be apparent initially with its clinical presentation. But if you think a child is rapidly regressing in his or her milestones, and that too in multiple milestones, if the child has multiple different neurologic presentations at a time, that means the child has seizures, muscle weakness, difficulty in swallowing, and other neurologic complaints, or if the child has some dysmorphic or coarse facial features, that's when I would refer them to the neurogenetics clinic. A lot of ataxia, disorders of balance, movement disorders have a genetic overlap with the presentation. So I would potentially refer these patients to the neurogenetics clinic. However, I would emphasize that if things don't make sense, if you're not sure, always feel free to call our clinic and ask us, or refer to a general pediatric neurologist as well, and they would initiate a workup. And if they feel this is potentially going in the direction of a potential genetic disorder, then they would refer that patient to me. So if a physician wants to refer his or her patient to the neurogenetic clinic, I would say it's important to counsel the families what to expect from the clinic and what we exactly do in the clinic. It's always helpful to do some basic blood tests, like a blood count, chemistries, and checking liver and kidney function tests to have at a baseline, that I would anyway do in the clinic. If the child has new onset seizures, it's always helpful to do a baseline EEG test in advance. In terms of imaging, I would say maybe hold off on that, because I might want to do any special type of imaging depending on the genetic condition I am suspecting.